Hi, this is the Mustang Chef on a road trip out to Silversides. I'm going to make one of my favorite desserts, the wedge cake.
Yeah. Now we're going to make the cake. And this is how I do it. To simplify things, I'm making a box cake. Starting out with my liquid, I like to use milk. 3 eggs. You know. Dose. Trace. Some softened butter. Now, what I like to do with my box cakes to soup them up a little bit. So a little bit of good vanilla. And your booze of choice. In this case, it's Castillo, spiced rum from Puerto Rico. Now, we're just going to whip this up for about 2 minutes. Oh man, that rum smells fantastic. So you gotta love the stoves here. You got knobs up here for the tops. I'd love to have an overhead panel for my ovens at home. This is beautiful. And here we go, we're putting the batter in. What I've done is I've put parchment paper along the bottom side of this pan so that the batter doesn't run out of it. That's it, into the oven she goes. And now, I'm not a pastry chef by any stretch of the imagination, but neither were the kids that were on these subs back then. They had 3 months of school at the Pearl Harbor cooking school before they got on these, on the practice subs, before they actually got on these big subs here. So, but I do know a little trick here for my chocolate desserts, and here's one of them right now. U.S.S. Silversides. Oh, I forgot the R in Silversides. Happy Memorial Day, you guys. There's some great stories that came off these subs, like the hotel chef that ate so much he couldn't get through the escape hatches. Piggy Doll, I believe his name was. And then he had to go on a diet to get off the sub. And then there was Shanghai Nelson, who went to Shanghai so many times he acquired the name Shanghai. Coffee flowed forever. You could have as much coffee as you want. And they would add grounds to the grounds. Take a few out, add grounds, and that's what you call submarine coffee. You save a filter, you save garbage, less stuff to get rid of. To this very day, from when I first learned that technique, I still use it at home. As you can see, coffee grinders are nothing new. This baby could kick out some coffee in a short amount of time. One of the things guys like the most was hot donuts made right here in this old Griswold fryer. It's a shout out to anybody that likes those punchkis. I would love to have a control like this, full throttle on my oven. This vent system here was kicked on at noon for the big dinners, and noon on a sub was midnight because that's when they could surface in the protective dark sea. So the food would be prepared here, and in fast order style, plates would be brought down, set across here, and right out the window to the men waiting.
Is it ready yet?
Okay, let's do it again. Well, cake went in about a half hour ago. At that time we were on the surface, at which time we went into an evasive dive. Because of this dive, we were cruising at about a 35 degree angle down into the water, and the result, here in the galley kitchen, is the slant cake. Or, if you like, wedge cake. isn't a normal practice of mine to do the cake this way, but there it is. Your submarine cake to order. The classic wedge cake. Serve this one on the Memorial Day or Veterans Day, and you're sure to strike up a conversation. One of my favorites to always serve. Put a little ice cream on there. They made ice creams on these subs too. Wonderful, wonderful way to travel.
Okay, guys, it's time to eat. I'm going topside.
Starboard or aft?
I don't know.
Cakes weren't the only thing affected by a long dive. There were turkeys lost for Thanksgiving due to the power being shut off to the kitchen to conserve. But there was always the next day, and most young men coming out of the depression at home had never eaten better.
Now we just did an 8-minute video on this sub, and I'll tell you what, getting just this little bit of equipment on that sub seemed like kind of a big deal, but I can't imagine loading that thing up with cans and fruit and vegetables and meats for 90 days. That's got to be a battle in itself.